horse is a horse, of course, of course. And no one can talk to a horse, of course. That is, of course, unless the horse is the famous Mr. Ed. Go right to the source and ask the horse. He'll give you the answer that you endorse. He's always on a steady course. Talk to Mr. Ed.
Welcome to today's video. Folks, remember, when it's over, don't forget to subscribe.
Good morning, everybody. I'm assuming you can guess what today is and where we're gonna be. If that doesn't say it all, I don't know what does. Right now we're here at the Mounted Stables. It's located right across the street from our station. We're gonna go in and meet the officer that's gonna give us a little rundown of what Mounted does. We're gonna see if he's home, see if he's ready for us. About to head in and meet him now.
Hello.
How are you?
Officer Triana, how you doing?
Good, Nick, come on in. Welcome to Miami Police Mounted.
All right. You heard the man, Miami Police Mounted.
Thank you for coming by. Eh?
No problem. Thank you for having us.
That's excellent.
We've been waiting, and finally we made it.
There we go.
All right. So, what do you got here? Let's get it started.
This is home for us right here.
Okay.
Okay. As you can see, this is our office.
All right.
This is where we start the day, right here.
Okay.
And we have a roll call in the morning, like every other unit. You know, we have our roll calls for our assignments.
Okay.
And any particular things that we're gonna do during the day. With the horses or anything like that. As you can see right here, this is where we meet with the supervisor in the morning and the officers. We have roll call here.
I like the office, but let's check out the uniform because you're looking on point. Oh. It's a little bit different than our normal uniforms.
Normal uniform, exactly.
So let's take a look.
As you can see, this is our uniform here. We have a cross strap.
Okay.
This is our riding pants, very important. They have a little padding within the inner thighs, and then our boots.
All right.
Okay. So we have to look presentable out there in the street for the public. That's the image we portray out there for the police department.
Okay.
So we have to look good, and also on top of that, we have to take care of our horses.
Mm-hmm.
That means the first thing we do once we finish our roll call assignments,
okay,
we go out there and take care of our police mounts.
All right, I'm ready to go.
We go out here.
All right.
This is the home. We have the horses out here. The stable, beautiful stables, and the stalls, that's where they're at, you see?
Alright.
Then you have the gentleman up front here, his name is Javier Dominguez.
Okay.
He takes care of the horses, the stable attendant.
Alright.
If it wasn't for him, I mean, these horses won't be operated, but thanks to his help, we're out here, but it's not an easy job. You can see, you have to clean up after them. Every day.
Every day
we have to clean up after them.
Right.
It's very hygienic. We have to keep them safe and clean, you know, to avoid any down horses.
All right.
Sickness or anything. He exercises the horses. He baits the horses. Okay, as you can see out there, if you look out there, the turnout area, we call it turnout area, the ring. Okay. Every day the horses that are not working, they go out there and they're put out for the turnout. That's the term for the horse talk. So they go out there, they do their little exercise, and instead of being inside the store the whole day, they're out there. Instead of being on the street, they're out there playing around and running around and jumping, what they like to do.
All right, so you were saying Javier has been here for a long time, right?
Yes, sir.
And I know you've been here for a long time.
Oh, yeah, I've been here for a long time.
How long?
For now 27, oh yeah, 27 years, going on 27 years.
27 years, yeah. So that makes you the longest
mount in history here in the City of Miami Police.
Longest
mountain.
How many? 27 years?
Yes,
sir. And you're retiring when?
Oh, Columbus Day.
Oh, this year?
This year, it'll be like 3 weeks from now. Yeah, 3 or 4 weeks.
I gotta shake your hand for that. Right, no, congratulations on that.
As you can see, the stalls, they have the name placard on there.
Yeah.
And it gives them that's the name. So.
How many horses do we have?
Right now, presently, we have 11 horses.
11 horses?
And they're donated to us. From the businesses out there, the merchants, which that's very important for our work here.
Okay.
You know, making a business contact and a public contact, you know, community policing.
Yeah.
Those are the ones that fight for us if anything happens. But they're the ones that supply us with the horses.
Oh, I didn't know.
They come here, the horses are donated. They come here and they go through like a 3 months of evaluation.
Mm-hmm.
And we put them through all different things and what they're going to actually encounter out in the street.
Okay.
Some horses, you know, people donate them because they have the little issues. So we have to work around those issues. And when they pass a 3 month evaluation, the horses, we assign them to an officer, and then the officer works with that mount, the police mount, and we'll be out there in the street. And they give us, some of them give us many years of service, some give us, you know, several years of service.
Yeah.
Depending, you know, it's stressful for them out there.
Yeah.
I'm talking a little briefly about Mo.
All right.
He came from the state of Kentucky, and he made a great transition by, you know, working with us out here as a police mount. So he came from an open, wide area working with cattle to downtown Miami, and you could see.
Yeah.
You only have like 3 feet or 4 feet of space working in between the vehicles and the traffic lane.
Yeah.
So it wasn't easy the first week. But here he is. He's been here so far like 7 years now with us, you know.
All right.
And
so
it worked out.
You adjusted well.
It's all the translation, the training, working with them.
Okay.
That's the whole thing, is building that bond between the mount and the police officer. Okay, the rider.
Okay.
And he puts that trust in the rider to get him through any the obstacles.
Okay.
And that's the way it is with this field of working with horses. When you're out there in the street patrol, it's building that bond, and then you accomplish a lot of things.
But I know it's hot in Florida, it's sticky right now. You guys have
very important here, yeah, for, you know, that being installed. As you can see that we have fans, you know, fans for them, so, you know, the air circulation here.
Okay, so
circulation. And also, I mentioned earlier, part of grooming is, if you can see over there inside on top of the store, there's a nozzle up there.
Yeah.
That's all the flight control system that we have here. It's very important. That's why we have Harvey Air.
He
cleans up the stable attendant. He cleans up for the morning.
Right.
Takes all the trappings, takes all the urine.
Yeah.
Cleaned out of there. Fresh shavings, that's the bedding. Fresh shavings, the bedding in there in the stall,
yeah,
is added to it, okay? That reduces flies.
Okay.
Okay, and also that fly control system that we have throughout the barn.
Yeah.
That's another means of controlling those flies, because flies are very deadly to the animal. One fly could put down 1,000 to 200 pounds, believe it or not.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah, well.
Now I know.
That's the way it is, okay?
All right.
Come on, boy. Come on. This simple thing that I'm doing here, walking. We train because you have to make sure you have a safe zone. You have a safe zone around your horse. Okay, that safe zone is like an arm length around your horse. If anything happens, you have time enough to push away. If you walk too close, let's say, and you get startled, something startles you, you get scared, throws yourself behind you, what's going to happen? He could knock you over. Or he could step, his hoof could step on your boot. So you have to be very careful. This is part of training. It's a just simple thing. It's how to walk your horse, to lead your horse. Okay, right now we're going into the area where it's called a wash rack. The wash rack here, this is at the end of the day. Oh, when we finish, we bring them out here and we rinse them off because they're sweaty, and we take off their equipment, okay, and rinse them off and let them relax a little bit. Then we put them in the stall where their feed is ready for them.
Breakfast time. What's on the plate?
They get fed twice a day.
Twice?
All right. Dinner time, okay?
All right.
Twice a day. So this is called the feed room.
Feed room.
This is where they have the goodies. As you can, if you take the smell of that coming out, that's the hay.
Hey. Hey. right.
They're fed twice a day, like we say, okay? They get each horse gets one scoop.
Okay.
In the morning, one scoop in the evening, and they get two flakes.
Two flakes. What's a flake?
Flakes are two pads.
Okay.
What are two pads? This is.
Okay.
And here there's two. One, they divide. You see two.
Yeah.
They get two in the morning and two in the evening time. Now, let me go to the pellets here. This is what they consume a day. It has the oats and the corn in there, all the grains and all that. Okay. And here, and these pellets, they have also vitamin and minerals that are inside of the pellets, okay? Special feed.
All right, where are we going now?
All right, now we're finished with the feed.
All right.
Let's go over to, it's called the tack room.
Tack room.
It's where we keep our equipment for the horses.
Okay.
We're talking about the saddle.
All right.
Saddles, okay. And as you can see, the bridles and the bits and the rings, okay? This is where the officer is assigned a saddle and we place it here. And this is in the morning when we finish grooming them, we get a blanket. We have a blanket. The blanket is next to us over here.
Okay.
We place it on the horse's back. Then we place the saddle and we place the bridle that goes around their head.
Mm-hmm.
And then the bit is what goes inside their mouth. What is that? What does a bit look like? This is a bit right here. This goes inside their mouth, okay?
Okay.
This is to control the horse. It's the brake.
Okay.
But it's very important. You have to learn how to use all this. It's just a lot of people out there that really don't know anything about horses. When they start horseback riding, they have heavy hands. They start yanking. And you're going to do damage to the poor horse's mouth. They can't talk.
Yeah.
But you're going to be pulling and pulling. That's going to hurt the horse's mouth. So we teach to work with your hands how to ride soft. Not hard-handed, but soft-handed. Let me show you.
Show me.
We have the horseshoes.
That's right.
Well, remember when I was out there grooming?
That's right.
I was showing you about the horseshoe, very important part about grooming.
Yep.
Is to make sure the horseshoe is not loose on the hoof. So as you can see, we have a supply here, different sizes for all the, horses have different sizes of horseshoe,
believe
it or not. Okay. The bigger they are, the bigger the hoof they have.
Sounds good.
Okay, so these are the horseshoes. This is called Boreum.
Is that a Nike?
Yeah, that's a Nike. That's the best we got.
That's a Nike.
Right here. Like I say, this world of horse is very complex.
I see that.
A lot of things.
I see that.
It's not just that we're here. Yeah, it's not just getting on there, jumping on, and high old silver and take off. No. You do that, you'll probably be on your back real quick.
Yeah. All right. Well, Officer Triana.
Thank you, Nick.
I appreciate the time.
It's been a pleasure.
Yeah, and I'm coming back.
No problem. You're welcome. All right. And anybody that wants to come here, come on over.
All right. All right, sounds good. Right. Thank you for your hospitality. I'm gonna go out there with Officer Valadares and check out how you guys do it on the road.
Excellent.
All right, sir, you be safe.
Take care, you too. Bye. Right.
Bye.
What's up, dude? What's up? What's going on? Oh.
All right, before we get started, there was a couple mistakes I made in the last vlog. I forgot to put Matt's handle, you see here. So it's gonna be at SBD supporters. Again, it's at SBD supporters. Thank you, Matt, for sending in the patch, and you guys go follow him at SBD supporters. That's my bad. And then you guys pointed out we got the patches from Norway, and I forgot to show the patches. So guess what? Here they are. See? Garter Mowen. I'm guessing that's the way you say it. So there they are. Thanks again for sending them in. That's my bad, my error. All right, moving forward. Got some more mail. Just keeps coming. It's amazing. First one's from Germany. The letter even has a German flag as the header. Very nice. See, and the sender is Romano Arnado. Says, hello Nick, first wanna say that my English is not the best and that I'm loving your videos. This patch, which I send to you, is from the Bavarian Police Department called Bayerische Polizei. In Germany, they are not easy to get, and if you find one, they are really expensive, so I hope you have a nice place for it. He even sent what the police cars look over like in Germany, a BMW, nice! And this is the police patch here, very cool. Rubber too. Thank you, my friend Romano. Appreciate it. All the way from Germany. Wow. That's pretty cool. And I'm gonna put this stuff up. You guys, we're working on a patch board. It's coming soon. Coming soon to a vlog New Year's. Let's move on. Got some more mail. It's great. It's great stuff. This one is from, looks like Maryland. All right, and it's a note. Letter reads, what's up, Nick? It's your boy Lou. Hey man, keep doing what you're doing. You're very special. I like to see the positivity, and you're all about that. Please accept these gifts as kindness and support. Shout out to Miami Police Department, the city of Miami, and all your subscribers. So Lou's giving you guys a shout out. And for Keisha Fierce, which I think he means Tisha Fierce, you're always very professional. You deserve this. It must be fun working with Nick. Be safe. Nick, keeping it real. Be safe. Keep making the MPD and the city of Miami shine. Thank you. Man, that's awesome. And Tisha, look what Lou sent Tisha. Go.
Hi, Lou. It's Tisha here. Thank you so much for the gift card. It makes me really happy. I absolutely love donuts, especially Dunkin' Donuts. So thank you so much. And here's to you.
Yay. You might as well just give me that because I'm the one who's going to be getting your donuts for you.
Okay.
All right.
You just made Tisha very happy.
And you just made me have to go to Dunkin' Donuts again. Thanks, Lou. Appreciate it. Oh, and he sent the patch from the Sheriff's Department, County of Plymouth, Massachusetts. They even got a little shift there. But thank you so much. He's just gonna enjoy this. And guess what, guys? That means there's gonna be round two of Donut Camp. And this one's from across the way, the Bomberos Hockey Club, Miami Beach, our neighbors. Let's see what's going on here. And the letter reads, hey Nick, this is Donovan from Palm Beach County Fire Rescue and the South Florida Bomberos Hockey Club representing Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach local fire departments. We have two City of Miami Fire Department players. Just wanted to let you know we love the vlog and totally support all the good work and awareness your team is doing for the community and public service. Keep up the good work. Donovan Cuff, Assistant Captain of Bomberos Hockey Club. And don't forget to follow us on Instagram. Here's the handle, @Bomberos Hockey Club. Go check them out. That is pretty cool. And they sent, oh yeah, South Florida Bomberos hat. Sweet. Oh, digging the hat. Oh yeah, South Florida Bomberos Hockey Club. Check them out. And they sent a decal. Very nice. Adding it to the collection. Bam. Also got some comments on the vlog. And a lot of the comments, believe it or not, guys, we're on vlog 32. That means there's 31 other vlogs prior to this one. So you guys should go check them all out. Start from one, make it a series, get some popcorn, check them all out. And a lot of the comments and a lot of the questions you guys have that you're putting on the comments, those are answered throughout the vlogs. We did dispatch, we did canine earlier. We've done a lot of vlogs. We've covered a lot of units, air units, so make sure you go check that out. All right, so getting ready to leave the office. Gonna go meet Officer Valadares out on the street. He's mounted up, so we're gonna go out there now and meet him up.
Thought I told you not to be vlogging around these parts.
I reckon you did, but I reckon last time I was here, you didn't like, share, subscribe.
Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. What you gonna do about it?
There's only one thing left to do. Let's vlog!
Hey, Mikey! Hey, how's everything?
How are you, buddy?
Guys, I'm here with Officer Valadares. He's gonna show us what he does on his daily routine as patrol.
That's right.
And we're here with, who's this young guy's name here?
This is Stryker. He's a 13-year-old Full Morgan. He's my partner. I'm with him every day, 40 hours a week.
Woo! Stryker, you're a handsome young man.
We're in Little Havana, more famously and also known as Calle Ocho.
Calle Ocho.
Yes.
Okay.
This is where I patrol. This is my beat.
Uh-huh.
I'm here 4 days a week that I work.
Okay.
And basically what we do on Mounted is we're a patrol support unit. So we assist the patrol units in calls, as well as maintain high visibility and make sure everyone's safe and doing what they're supposed to be doing.
Okay. So you patrol. You actually patrol.
Absolutely. I'm in service for calls.
All right. So it's not just a dog and pony show?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. We actually do work.
Okay.
So, you step aside. I think I'm just going to jump on this horse and Striker. Me and Striker are going to go off patrol. Can I do that?
Actually, you need an 80-hour training course that we take. It's offered here in the city of Miami. Officer Triana is the one that teaches it. I believe you met him earlier.
Oh, yeah.
And what we do is we learn the basics. I wasn't familiar with horses. I knew very little about horses. However, the great thing about this department is there's a lot of places to go.
Yep.
And once you come here, you learn the basics. You will fall. That is a definite. But you become proficient enough, obviously, to handle a horse in a urban environment.
All right. So obviously, we can't jump on there too, man.
No, we can't.
No.
Can't do that.
All right. So we're gonna follow you along.
That's fine.
Check you out on how you're doing your patrol. Maybe go up and down the beat a little bit. And you show us how it's done?
Let's do it. GoPro.
All right, you want to wear the GoPro?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, we're going to mount them up with the GoPro so you guys can see firsthand how it's done. And then we'll follow along in the car.
Great.
All right, let's get them hooked up.
We're on.
We're on.
All right, let's do it.
Trust myself, and he should lick me. That's what he's saying. So put my hand like this. Striker? All right, Striker. Don't bite it. Oh, he's licking me. Woo. He's licking me. He licked me. You gonna go investigate something real quick?
Let's do it. I'm gonna take the far left lane.
All right. Alright, so Officer Valadares is gonna go check out three subjects that might be loitering in the parking lot up ahead. We're gonna go and back them up and see what's going on. Just another day on Mounted Patrol. City of Miami, we have these signs, no trespassing signs. These are put up voluntarily by the owners of the building, and what that does is allow us to come out and check anybody who's on the property and see what they're doing, and they issue them a trespass warning on the owner's behalf. This is what's giving us permission. So right now we're checking out three subjects. One of them stated that he has a possible warrant, so Officer Valadares is checking them out and making sure that to see if he does or does not have that one.
According to our systems, You now have a warrant out for your arrest.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate your honesty. Now, at least, you feel a lot better, right? Okay.
All right, so what happened?
We had three subjects sitting outside of a convenience store. When I was talking to them, one of the subjects pulled me aside. He stated that he might have a warrant. I got his ID, I verified it was him by the picture, and I ran the subject on our record channel. It came back that the subject is clean, he didn't have a warrant.
So he was free to go?
Free to go.
All right, and you're gonna head back out. It's starting to rain a little bit.
Yep.
Time to mount up, I guess?
Yep, time to mount up, go back. The procedures we did in the morning with Triana, we do the reverse now.
Okay.
We cool off the horse, we rinse him down, and tomorrow's another day.
All right, sounds good. All right, so who wants to sign off? You're gonna sign off?
Yeah, I'll sign off. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. We'll see you next time.
Adios.